So welcome back. Here comes the short afternoon session. So right now we are able to connect to a test database. We are able to load the content of the database. The question is, and the problem is that actually I create every attribute as a string and I read it as a string, which is not very nice. We should learn how to store the information. Of course, using the JDBC data, we actually have everything that we need. The question is, how can we access that information? First of all, let's just run again and see what kind of data do we have. So I load the circular DBA again. I just remove to one more now, just because. So, I have the JDBC connector. I send an init message. And then I send the process message. And I want to see what kind of values do I receive actually here before changing them to so this is integer. How about just learning what kind of data do we have? So I have an integer, I have a string, timestamp, and each integer again. Well, what I would like to say is that now I want to go back to the basics. So continue, there's no problem. I don't want to think about it right now. So I have the attribute definition, and No. What I did before is that I have set the outdef type to identifier. Now I will have to fix this and I have the column data. I should have thought about that before. Right now, I want to fix it. How can I fix it? Now let's say that I create, okay, just put it over here, because what I want to do is that okay. And the attribute definition, the attf type, I just set to null. So clear the actual definition. And I also want to put that on a test entity. To detect it's a new hash set, and I just say that to detect add and if, of course it's again not the nicest solution, but I don't really care. What I want to do here is that if to detect contains a def, okay, of course if it's not null. Because if it's a null, then I will just set it to null. Detect contains, then I want to sort out actually I should be able to just set it to the real value. If integer class is instance value. How does it go? If I check, integer is a number. Number search hierarchy. Hoo-hoo. Number. And they are just independent from each other. Okay, but if number is the value, then I think I can check it from for being either a double or a float. Double. Or float. Then outdef, the outdef type will become addDef double. Okay. What else do I have? Double. Bool identifier long. Okay, so if it's numeric, but it's not floating point, and then I, sorry, vol type. Equals, let's say, row. Ah, just for fun. And I will finally set this to whatever. Well, type. Type would be equal to double. No, it's not that way. It's not a set, it's map. Everything is a factory sooner or later. And the story is that in the hint, I will need the value. So object value equals hint, the first hint, and sorry, hints. And I don't add anything. Will be the key. That's why I want to copy from here immediately. So, first, I think it would be an identifier. If it's a double, then it will be a double, else this will be a long, whatever it was. Long, else. Boolean. Class is instance value. Then the void type will be bool. I don't handle dates. That's so let's say, okay, of course, the most likely type is the number, but of course it is something like string. Identifier. And it's about type, and of course return all type. And it would be a def row. We'll see. And value, then do I need? Mm. types. And the first hint is the value. But I will not use it right now. And that way I can just set it to the proper object. Hopefully. No. No, I will need that. Because switch what type? To handle all cases, and I don't want to handle default. So active pool, there's no problem. If it's a def identifier, then it's a string. If it's a def raw and other things, it's like if it's numeric, then it's a numeric number value double value just to make sure that it works in a proper way. Long value. And with the raw, I don't do anything. But as I have successfully corrected the type of the value, I can just easily set it to the value. So right now I am learning the content from a record set. Of course, this is not the best way because I know it initially from the metadata. So that shouldn't be a problem. Something I want to see. I go with the process, and let's see, I started to read this integer. It's a long. It's identifier. It's also identifier. Yeah, of course. It's now a timestamp. Damn it. I should have set it this way. At least the last one will have it properly set. And it now reads it all. But I can repeat it, and during the repetition, I will properly set all of them, because now I see that the value type is outdef long for the actor ID. First name is an identifier, last name is an identifier, and a timestamp is a row. So I know how to set this up. And so, if I look at this actor, check if the actor ID is long, last update is raw, first name and last name are identifier. That's very nice. So of course, it shouldn't be detected from the actual values, but for now, it's okay, I can read it. The real question is that I would like to handle the foreign key relationships. Foreign key relationships. Let's do it. This means I come up here again, and I know that in the table info, at this point, I'm actually dumping the DB meta. Do I call this at all? Let's see if the init gets me here. It does! Very interesting. So let's see how it goes. Just clear the output and see p keys. So the actor, in the actor table, I say that the actor ID. Okay, so here I should set the BK name to what? PKs. But a table may have multiple primary keys. So actually that was a bad idea. To make And I will not have the column info when I so hash key info, foreign key info. Primary keys. So it says that when it comes to the table category, table schema. Table name is actor, column name is actor ID, key sequence is true, and prime PK name primary. Interesting. How can I use it now? Anyway, now just make it simple. Just name should be equal to RS get the get value get string and the column label is column name. So the column name is set later on, of course. I will handle that thing. And with the foreign keys, I will do something like the table info F keys. Name, and I want to say that okay, F keys get name RS. But I should dump this first. JDBC utils dump result set. press. Column names will stay. So now I get the PK name is actor ID. I'm quite happy with that. I'm dumping it and I say that PK table priority column name. What happened here? Oh yes, there is nothing here. Very nice. So I should just defer to the place where I will have foreign key. Here we are. So we say that the PK table F key table name. My table name here is address. Yes, in the address table, city ID. And the F key column name. This is actually my column name. And yeah, I want to go in here. Yeah, I guess it's simply too early. Too early to get but I will get here and I will receive this information. And just like go. And I can close it again. So what I want to do is that string primary table name, primary column name, foreign. Okay. Name. Because the primary table, from the primary table name, I will know everything. So this FK name equals FK name and the primary table name is get string and this is where I go like this. Okay, surround with try catch. Why do I have to surround with try catch? This is a factory in here, and a table in four, and it doesn't throw, it does not throw exception. But I should send it there. So anyway, I just wrap it around. It should be throwable. Throwable. And you know, runtime exception. Come on, let's just read through this problem. But now I know the information. Okay, and make it this verified private. And say that this is a good moment, because at this point I can set up the links for the foreign key columns. Because when I run over load DB meta, it's already done. Okay then. It can be done in the load DB meta. Just forget about this verified thing. Load DB meta. Wow. That's great. That means I already have the columns. Oh, that's much nicer. That's much nicer because I have already processed the columns. So as I process the columns, then the load DB meta can actually handle the column immediately. Really interesting. That means I must have
Info. I could even use the column as the key, the column info.
Wow. Good. So you just come down here. As I say, I want to have this column info P key. And string name call name equals that, and pk equals columns get call name, and it must be there already, and that's very good. And for the F keys, I do the same thing. In the F keys, I can use the column info as key. Call data. And how about saying that I just put it there? F key info. Then I don't need this. But if it's I can just say that it's a primary key. Wow. And this way I don't need this either, which makes the system a bit cleaner. Primary key equals true. That's all. And so I can have multiple columns with the primary key role. And I would just say that F key info equals new F key info call name RSF key def, and as we are here, what if I don't use it at all? I just say that F key info And dust JDBC utils map from result set RS. Okay, this thing should be the same as here. Okay, just throw it. Is there any problem here? But why is that? Because that does it. Okay, just surround with try catch and do a wrap. Oh, come on. Wrap and rethrow. And the throw ball is E. I knew that there is somewhere. Okay, so in the JDBC connector, now I'm collecting primary key flag and the foreign key info for any column info. And problem is that when I create the column, it is not yet set, but again, I can learn. So first of all, First of all, column name, ref processor, get object one to string. That's the ID. But instead of this, I would like to see something that and I want to say that PKE tags is null. If call info primary key PK index equals okay. Call index call column index. That's very nice. And I have to, okay, so the PKE index, I use this here, so now it's fine, I am reading the actual primary key of the table. But the other thing is, that I should check this table data factory should move to the table info. It's even nicer here. And this thing should be done when I construct the table info object here. That's very nice. I'm getting in sync with the meta information. So fact data put, that's pretty. And TI fact data get ID, cool. And the interesting part here is that at types comes here. But I will also want to handle the links. So when I go over the columns, I would also want to create a map entity to table info links hash map. And that's the problem. That's the problem here. Because that entity, oh my God. That's bad. It's too late. When I create this result set, then I should already know if this thing is an attribute definition or a link definition, and how do I know it? Let's see it again. That's the load DB meta, because I already have the attributes. That's quite unfortunate. So it says that now I'm setting the city ID. So here in my columns, the city ID. Info. I already know. Well, I should fix this here. Because just why not? That means
if null column name for Oh, that was a bad idea. Okay. Just utils access entity get value get value info a column dust meta links link def parent then I have to fix it. And as I go back here, do another ref process here with the link def parent. Of course, this should be put somewhere in. Okay, then just utils test. Access entity command drop entity column name for e column. Instead, I want to create an entity. Similar to here, but from column info a colon. So if it's not set, then I just drop it. Equal will be link def. Link def parents will be the e table, and link def type will be dust matter. Link def type values def set.
That's weird. Yeah. Okay, and if info fk info, then it's just an attribute. Otherwise, map links put and table infos pick call info fk info get, and the name was pk table name. There is a cast argument one to string. Okay. Calls. Call def very nice. And so now I read this thing and I say that table info ref equals map links get. If table ref, then we go with the actual version. No.
at this point. As data. The key is string that is a bit of standard TT. Just let it go. Oh, sorry. Really interesting. In general, it works over a bit of time. So probably I have successfully dropped the column that was created as an attribute definition because it's a foreign key and I need a link definition. Link def parent, link def type. And it's not a set. But it's a single, it's always an uplink. Single, this is always a parent link. Oh well, that was a bad idea. I have the city ID. I got a drop entity. So it came up. And what I'm interested in here is that I can say that the type address is an entity which has a link def, city ID, and ads def. So if I just see, I want to see the link defs here. Yeah, there are too many. But yeah. For example, the store ID. The parent is the customer. Address ID and store ID. That looks fine. Okay, so just check it out if I have fixed actor. Not yet, yeah, because it's just in it. Now I process the selects. And now let me commit my changes. It succeeded. So that's a very nice thing. Just come up again. Theoretically, I should not get any call in this point here. Oh no. And I should not have any information here because it's loaded. It should work. So it's a kind of DB. And it failed. Oops. Unexpected token value. Well, now that's a problem. Position 84. Just oh my God. Now that's bad. I tried to save the date as a string. D that was a really bad idea. And I'm afraid I won't be able to fix it. This is the point that I missed. For safety reasons. Well, well, well. I'm afraid there are too many of these dates. So I can't fix it. Let's see if I can come up from history. This was my last, and before that. Try to fix it. Okay, close. Launch it again and restore. This one. Star circular question generator text. Wow, I'm happy. Now, at this point in time, if I check the address type, it should still contain 9 attribute definitions because the city ID as an attribute definition now. Then I want to send a circular init to this JDBC connector. Now it does the type update. Just let it go. And after that, the attribute definition doesn't have, because the city ID is a link definition from now on. Very good. And now, let me
will it work? Okay, right now
the actor type doesn't have a link definition. So if I run a second process on the JDBC connector, here's now Susan, and I want to commit, and I close, and I run again, and I load the SocketDB. And succeeded. Very nice. And now it's Susan. So we suck the DB and just remove actor. Again, it's just because I don't want to open up the same actor again, and now let's see if I create any new column info. Most likely I don't. Because now my meta layer is in sync with the database content. So first I init, and it goes fine, and I then process. And it also goes fine. Now the question. If I can for example check the address actor info, now that's a view. City. Okay, I have two stores, manager, stuff ID, address ID. That is store. Let's see. section start from store stuff. Have the address what So, what do I see here? Theoretically, I should have two stores. Manager stuff ID 1. And select stuff from stuff. And it works. And if I check this address here, address, oh my God. Takes quite long. Of course, my environment is not really prepared for this amount of data. But actually it seems to work. So, closing this afternoon's shorter session, I was able to improve my meta connection layer by learning the actual data type from the values that I have just collected from the database. And later on,
I was able to change attribute definitions to link definitions, and the link definition actually work, which means, just in the previous example, I have loaded the store data table, and as it is visible, of course, the attributes, the store ID and the last update are normal attributes, but the manager stuff ID and the address ID are actually links to the stuff and the address table, and the entity reference is loaded correctly. So when I first loaded the store entity, it pointed to an entity instance inside my cloud, which was a placeholder for step one because of the identifier. But when I run the sect from staff, it actually populated this entity with the actual database data. So yes, I think this is all I wanted to have. And maybe I should just copy paste my relatively smaller circular database. And try to commit. It would, of course, take a while. Because now it contains all the addresses and everything. If we check it, oh yeah, that's something that I'm afraid I will not be able to load. But then I will just come back from the copy. Just close it. And load it again. And just sit down and relax, because that will take a long while with this amount of entities. Okay, load it up, and let's see if I have my dear store. And in the store, stuff one, I still have everything. It works as expected. And if I have just three. Great. So thank you for your patience in today's session.